My dear people of God, allow me to start our reflection for tonight from the beautiful responsorial psalm. Lord, you are good and forgiving. This response, this refrain to the psalm brings with it a beautiful message that when the Lord acts, He acts from a heart that is not just but good, not just but merciful. His mercy is beyond His justice. And in the old Hebrew, it's not even just good, it's merciful. And in the meaning of that old Hebrew term, it would be called hesed. Please think of letters H, S, D. Don't mind the vowels. There are no vowels during those time. So H-E-S-E-D, remove the two E's there. Think of hesed as making you, restoring you to the primal, to the pristine beauty of who you were when God created you to be. That is the way God's mercy works. That is the way God's goodness works. He restores us as if we've never sinned at all. What is the best way for me to explain this? Perhaps imagine that these pews are not painted white. Imagine that these are naturally painted. And I would say, painted with the natural color of the wood. And imagine that that plank where we sit may not be made of one piece or two pieces of wood. They've been connected. They have been connected with dowels, not just nails. And then to erase the connection, to hide the joints, the carpenter, who is a fine carpenter, not just any ordinary carpenter, was using ground wood with glue, mixed it with water, ran that glue mixed with water along the joints, so much so that the joints were hidden. They don't show at all. That is the way for me to describe hesed. Making something solid and one as if they were never connected. Making us broken people one again, whole again, as if we've never been broken at all. That is the hesed of God. That is the goodness of God. That is how God treats us. That's why in the beautiful first reading, the book of wisdom says, you are a God like no other, because you search man's heart, because you want to show your goodness first by being just and then by being merciful. And your justice and your mercy are not indicative of a weakness rather than of might and power. You see, to be merciful, to bend, would be viewed as weakness. No. On the contrary, God knows us so well that if He remakes us, if He recreates us in His divine wisdom, in His might, we know, He knows that we can be better than what we were before, than who we were before, because He knows our potentials. God is not done with us yet. We are in the constant process of being made and remade to be the person that God wants Him to be, wants us to be. Beautiful responsorial psalm, beautiful first reading, run them parallel with the second reading of today, and you will find that this 16th Sunday of the ordinary time is really meant for us to be animated, to be inspired. Who we are is God's gift to us. Who we can be is our gift to God. But we have to do our part. We've got to corroborate and collaborate and make ourselves open to God's promptings. It is because when He searches the heart, He also gives us the grace to respond to that search, so that when He cleanses us, when He restores us, that grateful heart will say, I want to maintain my goodness. I want to be at par with the plans of God. And if it's not easy for me, I have the church. I have the sacraments to help me. I have the Bible to help me. This is something that we rejoice at, that along the way, there is help. When we get lost, there is something that tells us, go to the sacrament of reconciliation. There is a God's positioning system, His GPS for you and for me. So beautifully are the choices of the readings of today that we could just exclaim and sigh, Lord God, help me maintain my resolution. I want to be yours totally. I want to be yours totally. So much so that if there is something that bars me, that impedes me from approaching you, Lord, remove that. It is because I want to belong to you totally. People of God, the parable of the gospel of today is an invitation for us to see if there is a column in a ledger, if there is a wide notebook, a wide spreadsheet, where are the columns that we could fit in? Where do you belong? Don't just talk about the mustard seed. Don't just talk about who we are. Talk about who we can be. But there is always an accompanying condition to that. To be the person that God wants us to be. To be open to His promptings. To say, Lord, help me. Maintain me in your sight. Do not remove your gaze from me, that I will always walk towards you. Make eye contact with me, Lord, and I will maintain that eye contact with you also, so that all the things that I do will be coming from a heart that searches for you, a heart that wants to be connected to you, so that one day we could be together in eternity. Amen.